we're going to be taking a look at the Dell XPS13. So this is a very small ultrabook slash laptop that I actually bought to use in school because I needed one at the start of the year. I wasn't planning to buy one. I wanted a Razer Blade Pro, but unfortunately we actually needed to get one like right at the start of the year, and I wasn't ready to spend $3,000 on a laptop, so I decided to go with something a bit smaller. And this isn't going to be a full, like, all the details and specs and everything, but I'm just going to give you guys a quick overview of what's really good about it, what's not so good. So here we go. First of all, you can ignore the front. I just put some white carbon fiber and stickers on it, just for protection. The material is made out of this sort of plastic, shiny but matte surface. Is pretty resistant to scratches. But it will scratch if you have something metal on it, like keys or whatever. So I do recommend you put some sort of vinyl protecting cover on it, like this carbon fiber. Looks pretty nice, and when that gets scratched, you can just replace it. On the bottom here, so you got a cover. This thing actually opens up. You have all the serial numbers and codes underneath there. So it's really nice that they actually cover that up, and that way you can't see anything. It has a really strong magnet, so this is really difficult to open. So that's not gonna fall off, like, ever. Here you got vents on the bottom. It does get kind of warm here if you're using it for gaming or rendering and stuff like that. So not so great to have on your lap if you're doing that kind of stuff, but other than that, if you're just web browsing, doing some work, you can put it on your lap and block these vents and it will still run perfectly fine. So that's pretty nice. These rubber non-slip pads here, they are very grippy, so you can put this down on the surface, it's not going to move at all. So it's, like, really strong. So that's nice. The hinge is very strong too. So that's not getting damaged anytime soon. The only thing is that the screen is kind of thick when you compare it to the body of the laptop, so some space could have been saved there by going with a thinner screen or something. But overall, it's actually pretty slim and very light. This is actually basically the size of a textbook, so very easy to carry around and just stick it in your backpack whenever. So let's take a look here. You can see the size of the screen, thicker than what you would find on, like, a MacBook or a Razer Blade. But yeah, in the 2015 model of this laptop, it's got a glass screen instead of this matte screen. I mean, in the 2016 version, this is the 2015. So they got rid of the matte screen, they put a piece of glass. One problem I had was that dirt kind of gets stuck in the edge over here between the screen and the bezel. And that's kind of difficult to clean when you get dust stuck in there. But basically that's been fixed now. So, glass screen, I think that's a pretty good improvement. Also, more resistant than this matte surface and easier to clean, so that's good. But basically, almost everything else aside from specs and the screen is the same in the 2015 and 2016 version. So if you're planning to buy one of these used, then just go for the 2015 one, and you'll probably find them pretty cheap. So, on the inside you'll find here this sort of carbon fiber like surface. This does get stained a bit. I don't know if you can see it in the camera with, like, the oil from your hand, but it's pretty easy to clean off with just some water and a towel or something. Yeah, touchpad, it's pretty good. Not the best clicking though. It's easy to click in the middle. As you go to the edges, it gets harder to click. So, not too consistent, but it is nice and large, and the tracking is pretty good on it. Not perfect, but pretty good. I do like the trackpad on the MacBooks better. The Force Touch feels just so much better, but you can't really get that on a Windows laptop. So, yep, that's just a trade-off. Startup, it's fast. This came with Windows 8.1. I upgraded immediately to Windows 10. I think all the new ones come with Windows 10 already installed. So, yeah. It's got an SSD in it. Nothing too big, but it is fast. So that's nice. And there you go. So now in Windows, you can see that it's got a backlight, which is actually pretty nice. Makes the keys very visible, and you can adjust the brightness and everything. The battery life of this laptop is actually pretty amazing. They claim, like, I think something ridiculous, like 10 or 12 hours. That's just if you're doing, like, editing documents or web browsing. Of course, if you do gaming, audio, video editing, all that kind of stuff, you'll get much less battery life. But I have made it through pretty much almost every single day, long school days, by using this laptop for hours and hours. And it's lasted me pretty much every single time, except for when it's a really long day and I'm going to be doing some gaming and stuff, then I actually bring the charger with me, which is actually not bad. The charger over here, you can see it's very small and compact, about the size of like half a phone maybe, except twice as thick. And it's got this really nice cable that you can just wrap around and clip like this, so it's very easy to keep it organized. And the only thing is that the power cable, even though it's short, there isn't really any way to wrap it around or organize it anywhere, but that's not that much of a problem since it's short. It charges really quickly, so about 2 to 4 hours depending on how much it's been used. And I don't have exact numbers on that, but I can tell you that it's very fast. And yeah, so I usually use the laptop at about 50% screen brightness. And yeah, overall the battery is great. The 15-inch version is actually a lot better. They claim 17 hours on that, so I would expect like several hours of actually just gaming on full power without having to worry about the battery, so that's really nice. Windows 10, I don't have Windows 10 on my gaming PC yet, but I have it on this, and it's actually really nice, very smooth. Haven't had really any problems aside from it like randomly updating sometimes, but that's alright. Overall, Windows 10 is great, and it works pretty well on this laptop. So, what other things are there about this that you should know? Well, Minecraft, since I play Minecraft a lot, is actually working very nice on Windows 10. This laptop, even though it only has integrated graphics, it can play at max settings and get over 30 FPS. I do recommend, however, turning down to medium settings and playing at about 60 to 120 FPS. So, that's a much better gaming experience. If you're playing games more intensive than Minecraft, then I would suggest actually going for the 15-inch version of this laptop, which has a GTX 960M. So, alright, there we go. So, can't really see it too well in the video, but I'll just press F3 over here. Whoops. Function F3. So yeah, we're running at about 30 FPS with max settings. And we can actually turn this down, let's put it to like 8 chunks, and set that to 120. Fast graphics, just minimum smooth lighting, and we can turn these other things off. And then we can go back in the game, and we'll see we're now getting 45 FPS, about 50. Not that bad. The fan in this computer is kind of quiet. It's actually on right now. You can probably not hear anything. So yeah, that's good. And yeah, overall, not a gaming laptop. It's great for productivity though. Photo editing, video editing, not so much unless you don't mind waiting for stuff to render. But overall, it's very good for working on documents and going on the web for stuff. So, very good school laptop. If you want more power, I would suggest going with the 15-inch version, which also has a bigger screen and basically just more powerful for like a few hundred dollars more. But yeah, basically the screen is what makes this laptop so unique. You have this very thin bezel, and you can get a 13-inch screen on a laptop that is the size of a usual 11 or 12-inch laptop. So It's very nice, and I do find that having a screen this big on basically almost the full size of the laptop is very nice. So yeah, if you're looking to do gaming and stuff as well as productivity and just schoolwork, I would suggest getting the 15-inch version with the dedicated GPU. But if you're just using this for documents and web and maybe some light photo editing or whatever, then the 13-inch model is very portable and it's very easy to just shut down and close and take it with you. So yep, it's a very good laptop and it's very nice too, high quality build, and I do recommend it a lot. So hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, I can actually answer them in the comments. And yep, that's it for my first 3 months of using this and my experience. And who knows, maybe in a few years from now, I'll still be using it. So I'll see you guys in the next video.